Hi there, this is Max, and today I'm going to show you in this video how to solve the first three exercises of 3.1. As you can see, I have drawn a flat plate that is perpendicular to the flow with a thickness D and length L as was shown in the exercise, where L is way larger than D. So in this case, there is quite a large stagnation point over here. This question was about the forearm drag and how it was influenced by different factors. Now, first, what was the forearm drag again? The forearm drag was when a certain fluid or liquid or gas has to deflect from the path it would normally take, and therefore it experienced some stress, which causes friction, or drag as we call it, and this is the forearm drag, where friction drag would be the friction created on the skin between the fluid and the object. In this exercise, we were looking at different scenarios. What if D would get bigger, but still L would be way larger than D? What if L would be enlarged? And what if we would change the scenario and let flow come onto the plate from a different angle? First, let me start with the first one. If D would be bigger, this section here would be bigger, and therefore there would be much more contact between the fluid and the object. But this would increase the friction drag, since friction drag is created between the skin of the object and the fluid. The forearm drag would not be the same, since this stagnation point and this area over here would still be the same. So nothing happens in this case with the forearm drag. Overall drag increases, but not the forearm drag. Two, what if the length would be larger? In that case, this part would have more length. Therefore, the air also has to go out of the way more. And as we said, forearm drag is created when the fluid or gas has to deflect from its normal path. So the stagnation point even grows bigger. This grows more messy. And therefore, the forearm drag increases. Now what if we would change the direction or the orientation? So let me draw this a little bit bigger. Flow would be coming in here and would flow around the object, also creating a stagnation point over here. And of course, some vortexes and such them over there. But the question now is this stagnation point bigger or smaller than that one? In fact, it would be smaller. And why is that? Because especially the top section would flow relatively easy around the object. The flow beneath the object would flow a little bit less easy, since this really has to go with a great angle over here. But the overall forearm drag is decreased. This can also be shown by this orientation, in which you would mainly have friction drag and almost no forearm drag. In this case, friction drag is almost 100%, while forearm drag would be almost 0%. In this case, is in between. I hope you understand this explanation. Otherwise, please feel free to ask anything on the forum and we will be happy to assist you.